I got a freaky, freaky, freak. Give you a freak, you turn him out. I put the hose in the road and turn out things, no doubt.
Was that initial with Big Baby with these review pickups? These are old now because I had them for about a couple weeks now, but I have not gotten to the pickup bid to it. This one here is the pickup bid for my Julius Erving collection. Before I get into the jerseys, I just want to say that these particular jerseys took me a long time to come across because it was not easy to find the legit ones. This particular jersey, I've been wanting these for a very long time, but I never could get my hands on the real ones. Because every time I ordered one, and I paid a pretty big piece of money for it, and it was the knockoff version, so that's why, you know, when I did the video about the knockoff jerseys, knowing the difference between the five tier jerseys and knowing that the authentic is far better than the replica, but of course the game worn and the game issues are the best you could come by. And also the game cuts are the best that you can get. Mitchell Ness makes some great jerseys. So this particular jersey, if you ever found a game worn one or a game issue one in this particular style, like this particular year, it'd probably be no good as far as wearing it is concerned. Because these jerseys would date back into the 70s. So with no further ado, as I said, every time I came across one of these jerseys, it's always been the knockout version, but I finally got all the years, finally got the jerseys that I've been looking for. Let's get to the review. Alright, so the first one, of course, as I was talking about, was Julius Erving, the New York Nets Julius Erving. So this is definitely an older run. You have Nets growing across the chest in single stitch. Number 32 in single stitch. You have your panels onto the side, red going straight down. You have the panel blue with the three single stitch stars there. You see the old jock tag, size 56, 1964, 1965, 1975, 1976. On the back, you have another red panel going. You have Erving in an arch, single stitch 32. This is definitely an American run one. American made, you see it there on the jock tag. I don't know how many times I have gotten this jersey, but every time I've gotten it, it always was a knockoff. And it was pretty hard to identify the knockoffs with these here, but I got some photos in. As I said before, you would know a knockoff by the stitch. That is a nice small stitch. And that twill is, that tackle twill is great. So this is an older jersey here. Okay, so I was well pleased in getting this one. Okay. The next one. This is also American run. This is a more newer run. Not newer today, but still no jersey. Is the blue one. This one here has New York going across the chest, single stitch number 32. Same thing, red panel going all the way down, white panel with the single stitch stars on the back. Red Panel. Irving on back, and number 32 Irving. This is also American made. When I looked in the inside of this one, same thing, you know, the tag here lets me know that this is American made.
There you go. See, US made.
This one does too, but it's old since this was such an old jersey, and it doesn't have, you can't see it, but because it's been worn out for all the years. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and end this video. So I have my two Julius Erving jerseys. Interesting thing about Julius Erving, I'm going to go ahead and get to that right now. Okay, so the interesting thing about these jerseys is, why would the team that drafted Julius Erving at this time would be the Virginia Squires? Excuse me, you know, getting a little older, I guess. You know, the Virginia Squires drafted him, coming out of Massachusetts, UMass. He was drafted to this Squires team. I think around 73. He was drafted. Why did they send him to New York? Well, the story goes like this. The ABA has been in trouble since its inception because it didn't have a fan base like the NBA. The NBA had its fan base. So the ABA was just go ahead and be for real about it. ABA was looked more like a black league. It was like a Negro league. You know, they had white, you know, coaches and owners, but it was still a predominantly black sport because, you know, with the high flying, the dunking, the athleticism, the NBA didn't tolerate that. So the NBA was more white based. So the ABA was in trouble. And so to try to save and help save the ABA, the Virginia Squires decided to send Julius Erving, who was the best player. He was the Michael Jordan of the ABA. He was definitely Michael Jordan of the ABA. They sent him to this team here, and where he won two championships with the New York Knicks. And when the ABA merged with the NBA, it was only, I think, four teams. You had your San Antonio Spurs, the New York Nets, the Pacers, and it was one more team. I can't remember where the other team was, but anyway, these teams merged in with the NBA, and instead of him staying with the New York Nets, the issue happened is when, since they were coming to New York kind of fined them, so they had to go to New Jersey, and they couldn't afford it. There was millions of dollars short, so they had to deal away Julius Erving. And when they dealt away Julius Erving, he went to Philadelphia 76ers. So that's how he became a Sixer. And he came from the ABA to the NBA because the New Jersey Nets or the New York Nets had to deal him away because they couldn't afford to keep him in order to survive in the NBA. Okay, and I'm going to give you another story. I know this video kind of long, but I'm going to give you another story about these jerseys real quick. It was the Denver Nuggets, the Indiana Pacers, the San Antonio Spurs, and the New York Nets. I knew it was 14. It was the Denver Nuggets who was at 14, so forgive me for not saying the last segment. I had to remember exactly who it was. Okay, so now, the interesting thing about these jerseys too as well is these two were the original jerseys that I wanted first from Mitchell Ness, so that's going to probably be a challenge to you later on down the line. Because I know we got a lot of Mitchell Ness heads. I know I'm more of a Mitchell Ness head, so it won't be kind of fair, but I'm just going to have to put that challenge out there one day. So these were this was the first jersey that I wanted from Mitchell Ness. These are right here. Because when I remember the story was, it was a sports shop that existed in an old mall that closed down and was made into a strip mall. And it was a sports store. I can't remember, I believe the place was called Sports Palace, if I'm right. I think it was called Sports Palace. And it had these two jerseys and Will Chamberlain jerseys and a few other Mitchell Ness jerseys hit up there. But when I saw these two here, these bad boys was hanging, you know, above the the counter, the checkout counter. Man, I wanted these. I said, oh my God. And he wanted at that time about $375 for a piece. And I was like, man, I want them. And I seen this one kid, he came in and he dropped like $250 on that Wilt Chamberlain. He just dropped it like bam. Oh, also saw that Pistons Bob McAdoo. I seen that one too. I dig that one too. I thought that one was hot too. But I know I wanted these in the worst way. So this is what I did. I'm a seamstress myself. So I went to the fabric store, found, you know, some polyester material, and I actually made these. They were, I mean, good enough, you know, for someone who, I wish I still had them. I still had them, I showed you. But I made them, and I wore them. I rocked them. And you know, a lot of people was like, where'd you get that Julius Erving? Where'd you get that Dr. J? I told them, I made it. You made that? And I remember I wore it back to, at the time it was called Hancock's. Hancock's is shut down now. I wore back to Hancock's with the old women who, you know, because I was always going there buying material, making jerseys and stuff. So, you know I'm a real jersey head because I was making these. Not as good, not even half as good as these, but good enough to rock them. You know what I'm saying? So I will make these jerseys, and because I also did t-shirts, silk screening. So that's how I know so much about the, you know, screen print on jerseys and stuff like that, because I actually handle that type of material. You know, I made jerseys for Pee Wee Leagues. I've made their uniforms. You know, I put the image and heat press the image on there, so I know, or ink the image on there, so I know exactly what I'm talking about when I say, you know, when I'm doing jerseys. So I'm a seamstress too, so and it was so simple. You know, my wife taught me how to make the pattern. I took an old jersey and I lay it there, and I would trace the jersey out. She said, trace the jersey out about an inch and a half to an inch and a quarter, so that you can create the seam. So I traced the jersey, the front and the back, did the stitch, bam, bam, bam. Ordered the tackle twill numbers, heat pressed the tackle twill numbers on, and then I stitch around it. And I wish I would have kept them. What I do with them? I think we're moving. I just threw them away. I did something to them. And I remember I made some Michael Jordan ones. I made two Bulls jerseys, and I was, you know, in the elevator in the apartment we were living in, and I seen the guy, because I threw them away. That's what happened. I threw them away because I started to make room for the real Mitchell Ness's. So when I compared my product to the Mitchell Ness product, you know, I was like, man, I don't need these no more. So I threw them away. I threw them out. And when I threw them out, you know, so whatever other man's garbage is another man's treasure. That guy, he had them. He was rocking them hard, too. He was rocking them. And they look good. You know, they look good on him. You know, and I said to myself, I was like, Mom said, baby, look, you got a jersey I made. She was like, yeah, just don't say nothing. You know, because he was like, man, look what I found. You know, and it kind of made me happy within myself to say, wow, you know, someone appreciate my work more than I did. Okay, so I'm going to end this video. So that was just an interesting story that's behind these two jerseys. So these two jerseys are definitely girl pickups for me, because it took me years to find the authentic ones. And I, you know, and the two I had at that time, they were knockoffs. And I couldn't identify the real Mitchell Ness from a knockoff Mitchell Ness. So as time went on, I discovered, like, man, these two I got are knockoffs. Because, you know, I was like, you know, this twill does not match the twill of this one. The stitch is different than the stitch from this one. So this one has to be a knockoff. All right, so big ups to everybody. Peace to everybody. I want to ramble. I said enough. Told y'all stories. I hope y'all enjoy. Again, got my two grails, my Julius Erving joints. 1975-76. I want to say peace and shalom.
Man, you know, goddamn. Man, you know, goddamn.